St. Louis as Illinois and Missouri meet in a bitter border rivalry. Both teams are ranked and both teams trying to answer a call to greatness this year. The Illini burst from the Big Ten cellar and spent New Year's in Pasadena. While Missouri sent Chase Daniel to New York, the Tigers quarterback finishing fourth in the Heisman and is one of the favorites this year. Can the Tigers live up to their lofty expectations? Big 12 against the Big Ten, number 20. The Fighting Illini taking on number 6, the Missouri Tigers, just one of 31 games on the ESPN family of networks. Man, are we off to a great start. This game gives you the steak and the sizzle. Juice Williams, a quarterback for Illinois, last year helped rewrite the school's offensive record book. And Chase Daniel did exactly the same at Missouri, ending up as a Heisman finalist and throwing for 33 touchdowns on the season. And here we go. Hello, everybody. I'm Mark Jones, along with Bob Davey. Todd Harris down on the field joining us in just a few moments. Welcome to what should be another compelling college football season. Now, Bob, last year when these two teams met, it served as a springboard for both go on to record-setting seasons. This year's game is even more important.
Well, Mark, you said it. Both teams and programs had great turnarounds last year. I think the single biggest reason is because years ago, they both made the commitment to go to the spread offense. Just look at the overall NCAA statistics from last year. Offenses have gone completely crazy. Across the country last year, you set all-time records for points, total yards, and passing yards. The biggest reason, almost every offense is now running some form of the so-called spread. Both Illinois and Missouri run it, Mark, but they're totally different. You see right here, Illinois spreads the field to let Juice Williams, the quarterback, run it. Missouri spreads it to let Chase Daniel throw it about 55 times a game.
That's why defensive coordinators are running for cover these days.
They better pay
right?
These defensive coordinators a lot of money this year.
When you look at Missouri, 40 points a game last year, and they have a great receiver that really set things up. Jeremy Maclin. In fact, we got a couple of number nines to keep an eye on.
Mark, two great, and I'm talking about great wide receivers in this game. They're almost identical. Both wear number nine. Both are sophomores. Both are kind of hybrid combination running back wide receiver combinations. You mentioned Jeremy Maclin. Last year as a redshirt freshman right here in his hometown of St. Louis, turned it loose right here. Maybe the number one wide receiver in the country. On the other side, Aurelius Ben from Washington, D.C. Mark, we met with him yesterday, about 225 pounds. Follow number nine in this football game for both teams, and you'll know where the football is.
Downstairs to Todd Harris. Todd?
Thank you, Mark. Well, Illinois quarterback Juice Williams spent a week this summer working out in Chandler, Arizona. Why Arizona? He went to the home of Donovan McNabb of the Philadelphia Eagles. Now, the quarterback said the minute he got out of the car, Donovan helped him. He said, you want to be a quarterback that can run, not a running quarterback. And I had the opportunity to speak to Donovan McNabb by phone just a short time ago, and he said he just has juices. Just has that it quality. He says, this is a kid, if you blink, you're going to miss something. He comes in with a cannon of an arm, but he said more than that, he has a great attitude, and the fact that he would travel cross country to work out with me shows that he just wants to get better. The last thing that Donovan told me just before I hung up with him, he said, I fully expect Juice Williams to be in New York City in December. Mark?
Wow. What
we
about
met
that?
With him yesterday at the hotel. Uh-huh. When he walked in, you thought the same thing I thought. This is a big, big dude now. He is probably 230 pounds, more like a linebacker body type.
Guy that helped rewrite the record book for Ron Zook in Illinois, both with his arm and his legs a season ago. You know, Ron Zook, 13-23 overall. Nine of those wins coming last year after back-to-back two-win seasons. Gary Pinkle, the headmaster at Missouri, in his eighth season, all they did last year was go 12-2, although they only lost to one team, both times to Oklahoma. They are 3-0 against Illinois. All three of those wins coming in a row. And Matt Eller getting set to kick off for Illinois.
And keep your eye, we talked about number nine. There he is, Jeremy Maclin. Both he and Aurelius Ben from Illinois returned punts and kickoffs.
Maclin ran back three kicks last year, two punts and one kickoff. Going to be interesting to see, Bob, if they even give him an opportunity to return this kickoff. I guess the answer is yes. From the 7-yard line, Maclin looking for a crease following that wedge. A hat comes loose, and Maclin takes it out to the 32-yard line. A 25-yard kickoff return as we take a look at the starting lineups this year doing a little bit different, folks. Up across the top of your screen, the offensive unit for Missouri. Missouri with five starters back on offense. Derek Washington, the tailback, one of the key guys to watch. He replaces a very productive Tony Temple from a season ago.
When you talk about tailback, you're going to see this all night. Just the quarterback by himself lined up in that backfield. Tailback motioning back in there now.
First down and 10 for Missouri. Little receiver screen, that pass complete right around the line of scrimmage. That one going to Tommy Saunders, brought down by Vontae Davis, an All-American candidate this year on corner for Illinois. Chase Daniels, 6 feet, 225 pounds, a senior last year, the first Heisman finalist in Missouri school history. And last year against this Illinois defense, he really lit him up, Bob. Second down coming up. Given plenty of time and finds Macklin at the 38-yard line, and he gets rocked by the middle linebacker, Britt Miller. As we take a look at the starting defensive unit, a 4-3-4 lineup for Illinois. Jerry Brown, a guy coming off the edge as a pass rusher, number 99, matched up against Elvis Fisher, one of the key battles to watch up front.
And how football has changed. Last year, Missouri 45% of the time in this empty no-back set for the season.
Third and three, complete over the middle. That's a first down and then some. Still on his feet, Jared Perry, all the way down to the 30-yard line in Illinois territory. A missed tackle on the play by Nate Bussey.
And Jared Perry, a guy last year, had a sophomore slump, had a great freshman year. Last year as a sophomore, only caught 13 balls. He changed his number from 8 to 4.
Daniel, there's a fumble. Washington put it on the ground. Illinois says they have it, still waiting for a signal. And it looks like it's going to stay Missouri football. A bevy of impact players on the field for the Tigers, starting with their quarterback, Chase Daniel. Only 6 feet tall.
And I'm not sure he's all of 6 foot. We've talked a lot about Jeremy Macklin and Chase Kaufman. We list him as a tight end, but he is going to be flexed actually as a wide receiver just about the entire game.
First and second and 12. Daniel finds a man again. That's his tight end, the backup tight end, Andrew Jones. And he's close to another Missouri Tiger first down inside the 10-yard line. Bob, back to those wide splits. Is there a negative side to that? Is there a drawback?
Well, what you always worry about as an offensive lineman is being put on an island with nobody close to help you. You know, one of your buddies, the other offensive lineman, is a long way away, and you have some good athletes on defense.
They snap it real quick. Washington again. And Washington might have gotten a yard on the play. Now, on that one, the splits weren't nearly as wide as Pilcher makes the stop for the Fighting Illini.
And the reason they weren't as wide, Mark, they ran the football outside. So when you run the football outside, you want to close those splits down to allow that running back to get to the corner a little bit faster.
Second and goal coming up for Missouri on its opening drive of the ball game, an impressive one. We told you there was going to be a high-octane, big tempo in this game, and that's exactly what you've seen. Washington breaks a tackle. Touchdown. And the Tigers score first.
And we talked about Missouri spreading you out to throw it, but think back to the Cotton Bowl and their big win against Arkansas. They ran the football down Arkansas's throat for 323 yards and 4 touchdowns.
That's the second rushing touchdown of Washington's career.
That didn't take long, did it, Mark?
No, less than 5 minutes on the clock as it expired. Missouri averaged 40 points a game a season ago. Wolford in for the extra point. Wolford with a sparkling record, low snap, but he knocks it through. Derek Washington trying to make everybody forget Tony Temple and doing a nice job on this run. As the Tigers looking good out of the gate. We'll be back after this. Back at the Edward Jones Dome, I'm Mark Jones along with Bob Davey, Todd Harris down in the field. Missouri looked impressive on the opening drive of the ball game. Chase Daniel going 5 for 5 passing for 50 yards on a 10-play, 67-yard drive. Used up less than 5 minutes on the clock. Yeah. Devon Bellamy took his helmet off on that last play. Subsequent to that, that's why Missouri is kicking off from the 45. Vontae Davis on the kickoff return, and he's brought down just across the 15-yard line. First down and 10 for Juice Williams in Illinois from just inside their own 20-yard line. Three-receiver formation. Daniel Dufresne is the lone back. Williams under duress. That's how he can hurt you. Makes something out of nothing. Got about 4 yards on the play. Good pressure up front by Tommy Chavis from Missouri. As we take a look at the offensive starters for the Fighting Illini.
You look at Illinois, they look over to the sidelines a lot. They check the play an awful lot at the line of scrimmage. Missouri, on the other hand, on offense, doesn't check a lot at the line.
Second down and about 7 to go. A little pressure coming off the corner. Williams gets it off to his back. That's Daniel Dufresne. Picks up a few yards on the play.
Missouri with 10 starters back on defense. Going to do a lot more things this year. And you notice on the first two plays of the game defensively, Missouri with corner blitzes. Last year, a pretty conservative defense in this game. But with the experience, they can do a lot more things.
That last gain by Dufresne sets up 3rd down and 2 to go. This Missouri defense improved substantially as the year went on. After the first 3 or 4 games, they were one of the best in conference. Williams with a lot of real estate ahead of him. Stopped up right around the first down marker at about the 28-29 yard line by William Moore. And it looks like he may have gotten the first down. You can see it. And yes, they do give him the first down.
And you can see what makes Juice Williams so difficult to defend. I mean, he is truly another running back in the backfield. Mark, we talked to him yesterday. You could tell he's taking it personal that people think he is more of a runner than a thrower. He wants to prove that he can throw the football. There he looked a little tentative. He should have just taken off and ran the thing, but he was looking for the pass.
Williams completes the pass to his back out of the backfield. That's Ben. And Ben made a nice move to get some extra yardage. As we look at the impact players for Illinois. Juice Williams, 2 years ago, completed just 39% of his passes. Last year, completed 57. This year, looking to complete around 70.
And you look at Dufresne, the new tailback. They lost Mendenhall last year, 129 yards a game, a first-round draft pick to the Pittsburgh Steelers at running back.
To no avail, the run out to the 43-yard line. That's Dufresne, actually closer to the 44. It'll be 3rd down and about 2 to go. Got to get out to the 46-yard line. Ben, last year's conference freshman of the year. Played last year with a shoulder injury. Never even got close to 100%.
Played at about 65% all year, he told us yesterday. Had surgery in the offseason to fix it.
3rd and 2 coming up. Williams completes the pass. Ben still on his feet, using all of that body to have defenders bounce off of him, and a first down at the 30-yard line. William Moore came in to lay some wood on him, but it wasn't a good kind of wood.
Well, you're right, and it starts with the confidence of Juice Williams stepping up and throwing the football. That's pretty right there. Great protection. And now two big, strong athletes colliding, and it really has been. And William Moore, the safety, is about 230 pounds from Missouri.
There's a mushroom cloud forming after that collision. 25-yard pickup.
Big for the confidence of Juice Williams right there.
1st down and 10 from just outside the 30. Williams back to pass again, going into the end zone, has a man.
Oh.
Touchdown, what a catch.
Get Donovan McNabb on the phone.
Judson.
Make sure he watched those last two throws.
Will Judson came down with it inbounds.
J.
Judson moved over from the defensive side of the ball, and yeah, he should be on offense.
What a throw by Juice Williams over the outside shoulder, as every play is reviewed in college football.
Juice Williams spent a week out in Scottsdale, Arizona, with the quarterback for the Philadelphia Eagles under his mentorship and tutelage, and learned a lot about the nuances of the position, that time paying off. Eller will try and kick the extra point for Illinois here.
And that throw made the defensive back defenseless.
Has it blocked? Eller has his kick blocked. Stryker Sulik got his hand up there, number 38 on the line defensively. And Bob, you see it in early season games. The kicking game is usually the first place where some ill-prepared things might rear their ugly heads. Back after this. Back at the Edward Jones Dome, 7-6 the score.
You go back to Missouri, going for it on fourth down, provided fairly good field position for Illinois.
Macklin watches this one bounce into the end zone. He won't try and return this one. The first and 10 from the 20 for the Tigers this time. 1:26 to go here in the first quarter. The 22nd meeting between Illinois and Missouri in this border rivalry. Daniel completes it through the maze of defenders to his tight end, Chase Kaufman. Kaufman makes the catch despite playing with three pins in his hand. The result of an injury, picked up 23 yards.
You're going to see Chase Kaufman. We call him a tight end, but you notice he never lines up a tight end. Going to come right across the field right here, right behind the linebacker, Martez Wilson, on the crossing route.
Daniel's got some touch on those passes, doesn't he?
He's run this offense forever.
First and 10. Daniel's going to tiptoe out of bounds at the 43-yard line. Missouri had gone to this spread offense right about the time that Daniel became the starter.
I want you to see something. You talk about big splits. Now that's a big split. There's no offensive lineman. There's no guard in there. Did you see that split? That was a cavern. There was a defensive player, Mark, but no offensive player.
Under a minute to go in the first quarter. Daniel complete once again to Kaufman, and Kaufman pulling his way out near midfield, about 2 yards short of the first down, where Martez Williams stops him up. He picked up 7 on the play.
Well, you see the precision of this offense. Chase Daniel is about 6 yards deep in that shotgun, a yard deeper than any other quarterback in the country. He catches the ball and just gets rid of it. You can't get frustrated as a defensive lineman because you almost have no chance to get there.
So far, the running and passing game in sync for the Tigers. They lead 7-6 at the end of the first quarter. And this is the 22nd edition of Missouri against Illinois. It's the Big 12 against the Big 10. Back with the second period right after this. Missouri leading 7-6 as we start the second quarter of play. The Tigers on pace to pick up 720 total yards on offense if they keep this pace up. Third down and 8 for the Tigers. Up top, and a broken pattern apparently, and it's incomplete at the 10-yard line. Nate Bussey was the closest guy to the ball. Chase Kaufman was kind of in the vicinity for Illinois, but it's fourth down coming up.
You know, the strength of this Illinois defense is really the front seven. Excellent pass rushers. You're going to see Britt Miller, the linebacker, coming on the blitz. Britt Miller last year, Mark, played outside linebacker. They moved him to inside linebacker. And the kicker, ex-diver, is out on the field to attempt this field goal.
This one coming from 51 yards out.
This is his career long of 54 yards, longest attempt.
They got it down long enough and good. Jeff Wolfert from 51 yards out knocks it through. He hasn't missed a kick in conference play, and in non-conference play, he's also equal to the task. Jeff Wolford connecting from 51 yards out moments ago. Missouri leading by 4 points. Let's put the spotlight on tonight's Levi's 501 original. Bob Davey mentioned that he's a former diver. Several years ago, walked into Coach Pinkel's office, said, I'd like to extricate myself from my diving scholarship, give it up, and walk on to the football team. The rest is history. He is perfect in conference play in his kicks. And Coach Pinkel said he called up the diving coach and said, hey, this is not my doing. This is all his idea.
That's why when somebody comes and knocks on your door as a head football coach,
right,
always answer that door. You think back to Gary Pinkel right now, taking the time to talk to Wolford, who was a skinny diver that only played one game of high school football. This guy has been a weapon for Gary Pinkel.
And hurt himself, broke his leg in that
one game in high school.
He
kicked in.
Aurelius Ben on the kickoff return. And he's down at the 25 yards. First down and 10 for Juice Williams in Illinois. Well, this is about as far as Juice Williams was able to go in last year's game. Bad exchange, but they get it out to the 22-yard line. Striker Sulik made that exchange a little bit more tricky than it was supposed to be. But getting back to Juice Williams, he was the guy that was knocked out of the game last year.
Exactly. And last year, you see Sulik on the option right there, just take the ball and knock it out of Juice's hands. Illinois turned the football over 5 times in the game last year against Missouri. That's why they lost to Missouri last year.
A loss of 3 on the last play. Second and 13. Out of the backfield, that's Dufresne. And Dufresne with a nice move. Still on his feet, got the first down at the 38-yard line. Got a nice block up front from Fred Sykes. Sykes leading the way for the first down. They picked up 17. A little bit of touch on that pass from Juice. Here they come again. Ben. They move him around a lot. Tiptoes out of bounds at the 41-yard line. Picked up 2 on the play. True Vaughn's pushed him out.
Fans at home will notice Aurelius Ben went out of bounds right there. But the clock is running now. Changing a rule in college football this year, unless it's the last two minutes of the half of the game, if the ball goes out of bounds, the clock starts again on the referee's ready signal. A move to speed up the football game in college football.
I'm going to ask you your impressions of that, early impressions so far after this. Second down and 8 coming up. Nothing doing up the middle that time. As Ziggy Hood put the Ziggy on Daniel Dufresne.
Mark, we talk about those rule changes. When you mess with the clock in college football, you're making college coaches vulnerable. Because
how so?
You and I both know if you ever get that tag of poor clock management or poor game management as a coach, it's the kiss of death. This is 3 years in a row they've changed the clock rules. One of these high-paid coaches is going to get caught. So I just hope they keep it the same, whatever it is, next year.
Yeah, coaches are always looking for that gray area, too, to take advantage of, if there is one that exists. Third and 12. Williams under duress and sacked back at the 27-yard line by Sula. Karan Baston also in on the stop. Juice Williams struggling along with the rest of the offense on that last sequence, Bob. They imploded.
Illinois again a little reckless with that football. What a punt right here, though.
It sure was. Santella get off a great one. Macklin trying to bring it back the other way, and a flag down at the 31-yard line. Macklin brought down at the 37. We're going to take a short break. Missouri with a 4-point lead when we come back to the Edward Jones Dome. The Gateway Arch in St. Louis, one of the signature landmarks here in the city of St. Louis, symbolic of the opening up of the Western frontier back in the day.
Would you tell me today that's a lot bigger
it
than
is.
You thought it was?
Up close, yeah. Stevie LeBeau, our stemman, and I went for a little field trip. First down and 10. Another handoff. That's Jackson again. Bob, want to get back to that point about their tempo, Missouri. 95% of the stuff that they call on the sidelines, they actually run. A little different.
Yeah, most teams want to check and get in the perfect play, take a long time at the line of scrimmage to see what the defense is in. Missouri wants to get up there and just snap it. So they were 90th in the country last year in time of possession, which isn't very good. But it doesn't matter because they run so many plays and score so many points.
Second down and 8 coming up for the Tigers. It's picked off right into the arms of Walker. And D-Walk is going to walk into the end zone for 6. An incredible swing and change in momentum.
And you talk about turnovers. Missouri, one of the strengths of their program. Last year, number 11 with the fewest turnovers in the country. Their second turnover. And that time, number 91, Derek Walker. What happened, Mark? Colin Brown, the offensive tackle, was supposed to chop him and get his hands down. But Chase Daniel threw it right at Derek Walker.
It's as if he didn't see him, Bob. Walker got up off the ground pretty quickly.
He anticipated Derek Walker to be on the ground.
Extra point is good. And a calamitous swing in momentum for Missouri. Great play by the Illini defense. Derek Walker, maybe a play of the year for him. Illinois with a 3-point lead. Derek Walker with an interception return on a pass by Chase Daniel. And Missouri now trailing 13-10. There's a look at Walker getting a breather on the sidelines. Boy, it would be huge if Illinois could win this game in light of the fact that the Big Ten suffered a blow today, losing to Utah, losing to Michigan earlier this afternoon, Bob.
No question about that. That didn't look like a Michigan team at all, did it? Just personnel-wise, and obviously the new spread offense.
See what Jeremy Maclin can do from his own one. Wow. Maclin with a burst. He might have an answer here. Jeremy Maclin says, I got a little something for you. Touchdown, Tigers. How do you like it now? By number 9.
He gets a block by Earl Goldsmith, but I said, wow, watch Goldsmith 7. Just get out of my way. But he showed a burst last year in this game. He took a punt return for 66 yards. That's a big-time explosive player from right here in St. Louis. Not much you have to say about that return, is it?
No. Took it from his own 1-yard line. He was the only player in college football last year, Jeremy Maclin was, that scored a touchdown by kickoff return, by punt return, by reception, and by rushing. He's got 17 friends and family members here in St. Louis at the Dome watching today's game. Hey, remember Aurelius Ben? He might have an answer. Nice return out to the 36-yard line. Ford the deep back out of the eye. Juice Williams lining up under the center for one of the few times in this game. Williams buying time.
Oh.
Caught, and it's a catch at the 45-yard line. Fred Sykes wrested that ball away from the cornerback to pick up 20 yards.
What a great catch by the freshman from Tampa, Florida. And you know, simultaneous possession goes to the offense.
Williams back up under the center. First and 10 from Missouri's 45-yard line. And that's Jason Ford, the third-string tailback. They've used Dufresne, they've used Pollard, and now Ford getting an opportunity for Illinois.
And just to take a breath here, why the kicking game is so difficult in the first game. They did a study. The most injuries in college football occur in kicking game situations, particularly kickoff returns. So in training camp, you don't practice it live as a coach because the risk is so high of injury. So the first time you do it is full speed in the games, and things happen that you never would expect.
4-point Missouri lead on 2nd and 7 for Illinois. Williams on the option. Gives it to Aurelius Ben. Couldn't turn the corner. Run out of bounds at the 47. 3rd down and 12 for Illinois. From the Missouri side of the field at the 47-yard line. They've got to get to the 35 for the first down. Deuce Williams now working out of the shotgun. He was up under center several plays ago. Missouri dialing up some heat. And they got to him back at the 47-yard line. Brock Christopher makes the sack. Jerron Baston was the first one there with pressure.
You said it. Jerron Baston, number 96, gets great penetration, kind of flushes him out of there. And Brock Christopher, the middle linebacker, ends up getting juice on the ground.
Loss of six on the play. Santella with the punt. Little directional kick, tries to bounce it away from Macklin, who ran back the kickoff moments ago. They're going to try and down it, but they won't be able to get there in time. And it'll come out to the 20-yard line. First and 10. There's Macklin on the reverse. Stopped up. And pile driven back to the 18.
That's one of the few times you see gang tackles like that anymore in college football. I mean, with a lot of people getting on the football, the biggest thing the spread offense has done, it creates one-on-one open field tackles. Remember back in the old days when you used to have 10 or 11 guys swarming in those big piles? Very seldom do you see that anymore.
Makes you wonder when things are going to swing back the other way in the defense's favor, if it will. Second down and 8. Daniel down the seam complete to Perry. And Perry brought down to the 40-yard line. Good open field tackle by Trevon Bellamy coming over from his safety position. But a pickup of 38.
Again, Jared Perry from number 8 last year to number 4. Just beats number 31, Trevon Bellamy, in man-to-man coverage. Perry, the most improved receiver in the spring for Missouri.
He's been a nice compliment to Jeremy Macklin so far in this ballgame, Bob. First and 10 for the Tigers. Washington. Still on his feet, Derek Washington. Unremitting and unrelenting touchdown, Tigers! A 40-yard scamper to Pater for Derek Washington, and a missed tackle along the way by the Illini.
Yeah, two great blocks. First, Elvis Fisher, number 72, right there. Then Chase Kaufman, 45, and a missed tackle downfield by number 24, Bo Flowers.
That was just straight-up, flat-out sloppy tackling by the defensive side for Illini. The extra point good. And Missouri now up 24-13, but not to take anything away from Derek Washington. He kept plowing away.
Everyone's been excited to see Derek Washington, a great young talent. Here he gets a block from another freshman, number 82, Michael Agnew, downfield. Mark, you also mentioned poor tackling by the Illini.
Trevon Bellamy also had an opportunity to make a stop, and he wasn't able to get it done either.
In the Big 12 and the SEC, only 30% of their games are against BCS schools in non-conference. So give credit to Illinois-Missouri for putting on this kind of show here tonight. Because most schools, there's a bunch of directional programs getting those east-west,
north-southern.
Yeah.
First and 10 for the Illini. Williams completes it through a rope. Out to the 37-yard line, that's Fred Sykes. The senior picks up 17 yards.
Again, excellent protection, but the arm strength of Juice Williams, there is no question about his arm strength.
Todd told us about some of the receivers he worked with out in Arizona with Donovan McNabb, with the likes of Javon Walker and L.J. Smith.
And that's an amazing statistic right there. Illinois with minus 16 yards rushing.
Williams has time and has a man. Complete for the first down at the 35-yard line. That's Michael Manawanui.
That's a victory right there for me, Bob.
Yeah, I mean, his nickname is Uh-Oh, so we can call him that. But the big tight end, who wasn't much of a factor last year in the passing game, but anytime a quarterback can keep it alive like that, it's tough to defend the pass.
Dufresne brought down at the 35-yard line. Guy nicknamed Uh-Oh, number 16, their tight end. Someone who a lot of the players say will surprise people if you sleep on him this year. And when you look at his name, you don't have to buy a vowel for $250.
Yeah, he's not going to hide with a name like that. Plus 6'5", 274 pounds. But they did say they wanted to get him the ball more this year.
On second down and 10. Williams has kind of settled into a nice groove here and goes up top. Might have thrown that one away on purpose. Fred Sykes was the closest one. He had connected on his last nine in a row before that incompletion. It'll be third down and 10 coming up.
You know, we talked earlier about Illinois having 18 players from D.C., Baltimore area. How about Gary Pinkel with 28 players from the state of Texas? This year's recruiting class, 12 from Texas, only 9 from Missouri. He's done a great job of going down into Texas and getting guys that are a little bit under the radar, not super highly recruited guys. Chase Daniel is a tremendous example. But 28 guys from Texas?
Little heat coming. The receiver screen complete. Chris James made the catch, but it'll be fourth down coming up for the Illini. Chris James made the catch, a guy that plays all four wide receiver positions, but couldn't pick up enough for the first down. Brought down just inside the 35.
Yeah, this is a great effort play by Brock Christopher, a guy that lost 10 pounds. It's his 26th start. Watch 34 right here. Great play. I mean, tough on those offensive linemen, Eric Block, 62, to try to block a moving target out in that open field.
Everybody talks about the Tiger offense, Bob, but Coach Eberflus, the defensive coordinator for Missouri's defense, does a really nice job with this unit. And Illinois looks like they're going to punt. Santella going to try and hang this one up. Macklin calls for the fair catch at the 13-yard line. Macklin has certainly provided a bunch of pyrotechnics and fireworks in this game so far, and worthy of SI cover boy status, huh? Washington in motion to the top of your screen. Daniel. Boy, great touch pass complete for the first down to Kaufman at the 34-yard line. They got 17 on that play, and now we'll see some clock management by the Tigers with 1:27 to go.
You see how difficult it is when the quarterback gets out there running the football on a passing down to stay in coverage.
Daniel fires a little bit high this time. Jimmy Jackson in the backfield beside Chase Daniel. He takes the handoff and finds a yawning hole on the right side of that offensive line all the way down to the 40-yard line of Illinois.
Same thing that happened in the Cotton Bowl against Arkansas when defensive linemen play pass. Look at him trying to get up the field and rush the passer. Then when the running back breaks the line of scrimmage, there's just a gash there. So great scheme by Missouri. Just enough run sprinkled in there.
That pass incomplete. Intended for Jared Perry.
I mean, no question that Missouri has outplayed Illinois in this football game. But Illinois is still hanging around. But right now, this would be devastating, I think, to a tired Illinois defense to give up more points. If you look at their defense out on that field, there's a bunch of guys standing around right now and walking around.
At some point, you figure fatigue would play a factor with those guys.
So there's no question.
Bringing a little bit of heat off the edge. Saunders makes the catch, and he's brought down to the 30-yard line by Trevon Bellamy.
What happens when you start getting a little bit tired? You see the Illinois pass rush right there, particularly in a blitz situation. You come close, but you just don't have that extra step to get there. We talk about this football game right here. Missouri 343 yards of total offense. Illinois 141. Missouri with 43 plays to Illinois 29. So this is a tired Illinois defense. And the most shocking statistic, minus 12 yards rushing for Illinois.
Here comes the offense out onto the field for the Tigers on third down and one. Macklin, the inside receiver, to the top of your screen there.
I mean, how about his third down and one, five wide empty set of offense?
This isn't your father's offense. The quarterback, Daniel, keeps it for the first down and then some. And he breaks a tackle down to the 17-yard line. He gets 13 on the play before Bussey finally stops him.
Chase Daniel, check that play. Mark, look how they line up. Look at the gap right here. There's no one. So Chase Daniel checks. That's stealing right there. I mean, there's a crater, but the formation by spreading out those receivers makes you spread out. The same look again.
Daniel's going to pass it this time into the end zone. Touchdown, tight end Chase Kaufman. A 17-yard pass and catch, and Missouri puts more distance between themselves and Illinois.
And that's a tired defense. You see Nate Bussey, number 18, exhausted. They tried to play man-to-man coverage. Just no juice in their tank.
For Chase Kaufman, that's the 21st touchdown reception of his career. Wolfert with the extra point good, and it's 31-13 for Missouri. But keep in mind, last year, Illinois was down 21 points and rallied and had a chance to win it on the last drive of the game. The first half in the books. Missouri in control, 31-13 in this battle between the Big 12 and the Big 10. Let's go downstairs to Todd Harris. Todd?
Coach, you had the momentum and the lead in the first half. How do you get it back in the second?
Well, we got to go in there, and we've been here before. We're making mistakes that, I guess, obviously you make in a first game, but you don't want to make them against a team of this caliber. And we got to go in there and get our poise, come back out and do the things we can do.
What are they doing to take away the touches and the sights that the Aurelius Ben usually gets?
Well, they're playing good, solid defense. We're not doing a good job of getting the ball, number one. We gotta sustain some drives. We're dinking and dunking, but we're not giving ourselves a chance, to have a sustained drive and the defense on the field too much, and we're giving up too many big plays on defense.
Thanks for your time, Coach. Mark?
All right, Todd. Illinois and Ron Zook's crew going to try and find their mojo in the second half. Missouri leading 31-13. Right now, let's join Reese Davis for the Pontiac G6 halftime report. Back in the city of St. Louis, Missouri leading 31-13 against Illinois, number 6 against number 20. This after the Tigers trailed, but have since answered with 21 consecutive points. I'm Mark Jones, along with Bob Davey. Todd Harris down in the field joining us in just a few moments. Bob, what do you do if you're Ron Zook, the head coach of Illinois, to turn this beat around before the game becomes irretrievable?
Yeah, Mark, I mean, this may sound funny, but there's a lot of Illinois fans probably panicking right now.
Mm-hmm.
The biggest thing for me, don't panic if you're Illinois. I mean, this is the first game of the year, first half of football. Settle down, do what you do best, particularly on offense. Run the ball some, establish something. Last year they were known as a running team. Come out and run the football, because you have to give your defense a rest. On defense, easier said than done, but you can't give up those big plays. I mean, Missouri's going to dink it around. There's going to be some plays. Don't give up the home runs, but don't panic offensively. Don't come out here and throw it every down with Juice Williams. This is only the first half of football. You have a whole season left. You can come back if you just settle down and establish something.
Well, Illinois is going to get an opportunity on offense, Bob, to start the third quarter here. Aurelius Ben watches the ball go by him and through the back of the end zone. First down and 10 from the 20-yard line for Juice Williams in Illinois. Williams hands it off to Daniel Dufresne. Well, we heard from Ron Zook at the end of the first half. Todd Harris, what did Gary Pinkel have to say?
Well, with an 18-point lead, Mark, he said the most impressive thing for him was the way his team rebounded. They lost the lead and the momentum, but his team came right back. He also liked the way his team played in the second quarter, saying our offense looked very good. We tightened things up. He said, but we gave up two turnovers, which turned over to two touchdowns. He says, you cannot play that kind of ball and expect to win. I asked him, with an 18-point lead, any chance Chase Daniel will come out of the game? He said, that's way too premature to even think about that.
Yeah, Todd, he probably remembers last year's game against Illinois.
I bet he
Illinois.
Gave Todd a dirty look as soon as he asked that question.
And he did.
That pass incomplete, intended for A.J. Jenkins. It'll be third down and one coming up for Illinois. Bob, how important for the Fighting Illini to move things and show signs of life here early in the third quarter?
Yeah, I don't think there's any question right now. This is key because when we left at the end of the first half, Missouri clearly had overtaken the momentum of this game. This is a big third down here early in the second half.
Yeah, Illinois's got to keep its defense off the field. They were worn out at the end of the first half. Williams keeps it, gets the first down at the 34-yard line. And Williams and Chase Daniels, two of the more dynamic quarterbacks in the country. Statistically, Bob, Williams 12 of 17, but on the scoreboard doesn't have much to show for it.
Yeah, in the minus 19 rushing right there. Keep in mind, they got a little sloppy. They had some sacks, Illinois' offense. But they have to come out and establish what is the basis of this program, run the football somewhere.
Williams throws a dart complete. That one to Judson, and Judson has a first down at the 41-yard line. Good pressure by William Moore, but didn't get there in time.
Mark, this whole stadium right now, a little flat. They need a spark. This Illinois football team needs a spark right now. It's time for Aurelius Ben, number 9, to get his hands on the ball and electrify this stadium. See him right up here in the slot. We need to get him the football a little bit here.
Freshman of the year in the Big Ten Conference a season ago. Dufresne on the handoff, finds a crease. Dufresne with a little bit of room. And a first down at the 18-yard line. Got a good block on the edge from Aurelius Ben. And he picked up 41 yards in the process. And the Illini come alive.
Well, you said it. Big plays come sometimes in different ways. And sometimes a receiver has to make a block. Watch Aurelius right here. Excellent block. Knocks 15 Dell Howard to the ground, so he did provide a spark right there in a different kind of way.
Ben with a healthy shoulder this year, Dufresne on the sidelines. Ben's shoulder last year had him playing at just about 65% capacity. Had arthroscopic surgery during the offseason. It's fine now. No longer having to wear that shoulder brace. Williams keeps it himself and is brought down at the 20-yard line. No one to pitch it to. Well defended by Missouri defensively.
Has not been a good play tonight, the down-the-line option for Illinois.
What are the Tigers doing to slow that up, Bob?
I just think the experience, and when you play the first game of the year, you have a lot of time to game plan. You are going to make Juice Williams still throw the football to beat you. Not run the football.
Under 10 minutes to go in the third quarter. Williams looks over to the sidelines. Overshoots his receiver, and that one, too, was a little bit hot. Striker Sulak may have gotten a piece of that near the line of scrimmage for Missouri.
But there's a difference between a thrower and a passer. And right now, Juice, at times, is just a hard fastball thrower. But there's no question there's some tremendous talent in that arm.
Had 13 touchdown passes last year against 12 interceptions. They charted him during the spring and summer session, said his accuracy was up around 70%.
Yeah, he was 39.5 as a freshman, 57% last year.
Third and long for Illinois. Puts a little air under this one.
Oh!
And touchdown! What a catch!
He just went from a thrower to a passer on one snap.
DeVault makes the catch in the end zone, and Illinois right back in it. Juice Williams kind of hobbling off to the sidelines after that 20-yard pass for the score.
That is a great touch throw to Chris DeVault, who did not play in the first half. He beats Castine Bridges, the corner.
But both of his touchdown passes have been well placed against the defense.
And how about
touchback.
Chris Duvall? He was a corner last year. It's his first catch ever as a wide receiver at Illinois. Had a great camp, though.
Extra point good.
How about your first catch in major college football? Don't kick the football to number nine right here. Because the last time Illinois had any momentum, they kicked it, and number nine ran it back for a touchdown. So kick this ball out of this stadium.
Now they're not kicking. They have a new kicker, and they squib it down to the 30-yard line. All right, Reese, and back here, Missouri back on offense.
Remember last year we did the Clemson-Boston College game for the ACC championship at Clemson. Mm-hmm. Those fans were on Tommy about it. They'll be back on Tommy about it after this one.
They jump on and they break their ankles jumping on and off that bandwagon. Derek Washington falling down just shy of the 30-yard line.
One thing about a spread offense like Missouri, it's not like you can get into a protect the lead kind of offense where you just run the ball. They are what they are, so there's nothing going to change right here as you see him again in five wide empty.
9 minutes to go in the third quarter. Daniel. Complete, and Jared Perry has been his second favorite target next to Jeremy Maclin, and Perry has been very prolific today, 16 yards on that catch.
I think the thing you've seen, Mark, there have been some gaping holes in the man-to-man coverage, or excuse me, the zone coverage of Illinois. There have been some wide-open guys, but Jared Perry having a big night after that sophomore slump a year ago when he only had 13 catches.
Here's a carry by Derek Washington. Washington still on his feet down near the 40-yard line. And Derek Washington picks up a Missouri first down.
Derek Washington at 5'11", 215. Britt Miller right there is going to miss a tackle, 44 in the hole. This is an impressive guy that's gained about 15 pounds in the offseason. A lot of people have been excited to see him take over for Tony Temple.
And Tony Temple ran for well over 1,000 yards a season ago for Missouri. And Washington with a career high, wide open in the flat. The tight end, Chase Kaufman this time. Kaufman already with a touchdown reception in this game, brought down inside the 30-yard line, picking up 13 on the play.
Mark, that time Illinois really had a busted coverage on alignment. I mean, you're going to see just a wide open space out here as this play develops. What they're trying to do is zone blitz, but Chase Daniel's too good, and he finds that open hole in that zone.
Missouri has won the last three consecutive meetings against Illinois. Jackson in a tailback now, and he takes the handoff. Cuts it back down to the 10-yard line. He got five, so it's five, it's seven, it's sometimes bigger than that.
And what happens? This offense makes you tired, and Illinois looks really, really tired on defense. I mean, you look right there at Pittman jogging off the field. This defense right now has no answer for this attack of Missouri.
Daniel out of the shotgun again. Keeps it himself, Chase Daniel. Down to the 5-yard line and near another first down. Missouri looking at first and goal. Bob, we've heard all about Camp Rantoul, where Illinois had their training camp for a couple of weeks, and the heavy work they did, fitness training, getting in shape, but nothing can simulate going against an opponent like Missouri.
You remember Ron Zook on our conference call? I asked him about camp, how much scrimmage. He said, you know, I don't know. We scrimmaged less. We were less physical this year in camp than we've been, because I just didn't want to get guys injured. He was concerned, and that's one of the toughest issues as a coach. How much is too much when it comes to scrimmaging live in camp? But this is a beaten down Illinois defense.
That time Washington got a first down. It's going to be first and goal. The 11th play of the drive for Missouri. Under 5.5 to go now in the third.
See them a little slow getting lined up.
Washington stopped up for one of the few times. Missouri unable to pick up more than 5 yards on a running play. David Lindquist making the stop on the play for Illinois. Lindquist, a former walk-on who earned himself a scholarship shortly thereafter, And now is a key cog up front defensively for the Fighting Illini, number 94, making the tackle on that last play.
If there's one place Missouri struggles, it's normally in short yardage or goal line offense.
We're going second and goal. Daniel looking into the end zone. Touchdown. Saunders. They methodically move it down the field with clinical precision and score to answer the last score by Illinois. Now lead 37-20 for Saunders. That's the fifth touchdown catch of his career.
And that's a mid-season or late-season style drive right there by that offense. You talk about methodical. That was impressive. Think back, Illinois had a little momentum because they had just scored.
They cut the lead to 11, but the lead now back up to 18 points. There's a flag down on the play.
Chase Daniel to Tommy Saunders right there, man-to-man coverage, beats Duray Hicks.
A couple more Heisman ballots, maybe?
Too early so far.
Under a full moon, the Gateway Arch here in St. Louis, Missouri. The Missouri Tigers leading by 18 points. Juice Williams with some pretty good numbers. Chase Daniel looking very efficient on that last drive. Last year's freshman of the year in the Big Ten Conference. Going to get an opportunity here from the three. And trying to pick his spot. And brought down at the 28-yard line. Daniel Dufresne in the backfield behind Juice Williams. First down and 10 from the 27. Dufresne nowhere to go on the left side of that offensive line. Tommy Chavis making the stop.
You know, Mark, one thing as I see this, last year, Illinois, because they had Rashad Mendenhall at tailback, who was a first-round draft choice, and Juice Williams at quarterback, they had an identity. They're going to line up physically and run the football on you. Tonight, I'm not sure what their identity is. Now, I understand the game's gone a little bit different. They've been behind. But what are they going to be able to hang their hat on as this season moves forward?
Interesting point. Ron Zook telling us a couple of days ago, we will be a better team this year. I'm just not sure in which way. Williams fires incomplete for Ben.
Yeah, Aurelius Ben that time, Mark, let that ball get into his body. And if you let the ball with the velocity Juice Williams throws with it into those pads, yeah, it's going to bounce back out of it. You have to be able to use those hands.
Runza told us that the turning point for his team last year where they really turned the corner was against Penn State and then Wisconsin. And those two back-to-back weeks, they won. And up until that point, he wasn't sure that his guys really believed that they could win. And then they had the huge win against Ohio State. Looking for a little bit of a comeback here. Won't get it on this play. Williams brought down, sacked by Stryker Asula. Gotta love the name Stryker, especially when you play defense.
And Stryker Shulock looks like the quickest defensive lineman on the field. Of course, he's rested, but watch him right here on the speed rush against Xavier Fulton, an All-American candidate. That's a great effort. I mean, I've noticed him all night, Mark, playing with a great sense of urgency.
That's six sacks last season. Missed punt that time by Santella. Here's Macklin, always a threat to bring it back at you. Macklin gonna break him off proper once again. Macklin brought down at the 23-yard line. Santella, the punter, making the touchdown-saving tackle.
And you have to ask the question, why do you kick it to Jeremy Macklin? And then when your punter out-punts his coverage, why do you just punt the ball down the middle of the field? Last year, 66-yard punt return. This guy should be in the Heisman conversation. I really believe that.
They're going to have to work that out amongst the sports information department at some point this year between him and Chase Daniel. Daniel working out of the shotgun at the 28-yard line. Wide open! Touchdown! Saunders, his second one of the night. You never want to say that a team is letting go of the rope, but Illinois has to be at least a little disheartened right now, Bob.
Mark, they have given up some big plays, and that's been the biggest thing.
In two quick plays, the punt return by Macklin, great field position as a result of it, and in a pass later from Daniel to Saunders, and the lead now up to 44-20. Low snap, and a good job to get that down and up for the extra point.
Mark, what happens when you get tired on defense? That face right there says it all. But when you get tired, you start guessing. Watch what happens. Missouri's going to bubble this receiver out. The corner's going to jump up thinking they're going to throw the screen to that receiver. And the widest guy will run straight down the field. See, they thought the little bubble screen was coming. The corner jumps up, and it's just a wide open Tommy Saunders down the field.
And to Daniel with consecutive touchdown passes to Saunders.
And this has been a summer of hype for Missouri after the 12-2 record last year, big win in the Cotton Bowl. This team's legitimate. This team, if they stay healthy, will be right in the middle of the national championship hunt.
Really a spin from the 3-yard line for Illinois. And is brought down short of the 20-yard line. A 25-point advantage for the Tigers. Williams complete. Ben looking for a little space, and he can turn the beat around in a hurry. Dashing up to the 45-yard line, Aurelius Ben out of D.C. Missed tackle by Garrett.
Aurelius hasn't played great tonight, but he shows a spurt right here. Missed tackle. Watch the stiff arm right there. Oh, here it comes right here. Right there. Pretty good stiff arm on Carl Getz.
And you know, he told me, Bob, because of that shoulder injury last year, he was unable to use that stiff arm a lot of times.
Yeah. Hurt the shoulder last year early. Played all season. Probably should have had surgery last year during the season.
Picked up 30 on the last play. Williams completes it to Ben again. Spin out to the 40-yard line, and another first down for Illinois. Ben comes up hobbling. We have seen several Illinois players do just that.
Well, we were down on the field, you know, Mike Black, our spotter, and myself before the game. That is really a soft, spongy surface. A little spongier than a lot I've been involved with. Sometimes that brings out those cramps, but it is kind of strange because one team has them, it seems, more than the other.
Approaching 2 minutes to go in the third quarter. Williams keeps it himself. And Juice Williams with another first down inside the Missouri 30-yard line. Sulik brought him down.
Right here, you talk about the impact players for Illinois. We've seen Aurelius Ben on this drive, and now you see Juice Williams doing what he does best at the end of the day. He's going to be a good enough passer if he continues to be a threat as a runner.
He could really use Ben back on the field, though. He's being attended to still on the sidelines. Ben, the freshman of the year last year in the Big Ten Conference. Williams going up top, has a man open. Touchdown once again to Vault on an almost identical play. 26 yards for the score.
And the only question, did DeVault have possession of that football? He did. Another big touchdown pass to the guy who was a corner last year. His second catch of the night, right?
Yeah.
Two touchdowns.
Same play.
Two catches.
They got that play on lock.
Illinois going for two right here, but again, Chris Duvall, not a great matchup with William Moore at 235 pounds, the big safety nickelback, but again, the potential of Juice Williams.
They're going to go for two here. Down by 19 points. Duvall in motion. Williams finds his man. And it's going to be good. We'll get the two-point conversion. Daniel Dufresne made the grab. Missouri having to fight off a feisty Illinois team. Juice Williams from Juice. Vocation High School in Chicago, the same high school that Dick Butkus went to, another former Illini great. Did that work, as Todd told us earlier, with Donovan McNabb in the summertime, the starting quarterback for the Philadelphia Eagles. Interesting to note that Ron Zook says that Juice Williams is on the same type of learning curve and progression as Chris Leak was on when he had him at Florida. All right, Reese, and back here, the Tigers on offense once again. That seems to be the popular refrain tonight. Derek Washington, another popular chorus for another first down to the ground. Got about 12.
Tough duty being a defensive coordinator.
That's why you're with me right now.
That is tough way to make a dollar. I mean, I sit up here and marvel at these offenses and their playmaking ability. The more you spread that field, the more there's one-on-one matchups.
Daniel completes it to Perry. And Perry back after being shaken up a few moments ago. Got about 5 on the play.
The big question this year in college football, can defenses start to catch up from where the spread offenses have gone? That's the biggest single question across this country.
Second down and 3 coming up. That was the 6th catch of the day for Perry. Washington again, this time stopped up at the line of scrimmage with under 30 seconds to go in the third quarter. Tough day for the Big Ten Conference outside of Ohio State. Michigan State losing right now. Michigan losing earlier today against Utah. And that game was up in Ann Arbor. Aurelius Benn having a tough time cramping up a few moments ago. That's the end of the third quarter of play. Illinois going to need another comeback. Mark Jones, Bob Davey, Todd Harris down to the field. And Missouri looking at third down and about 4 to go here as we begin the fourth quarter play. Daniel completes it at the 40-yard line, but short of the first down is Chase Kaufman, brought down by Britt Miller.
Big third down stop right there by the Illinois defense. Forced Missouri to come out and punt this football. Aurelius Benn not out there, Mark, on this punt return situation. Still suffering probably a little bit from cramps.
Saw him on the sidelines toward the latter part of the third quarter. DeRay Hicks is back there in his place, and that's Vontae Davis, starting quarterback and all Big Ten selection, coming back onto the field out of the locker room. Illinois put a little heat on the punter that time, didn't get there. Hicks feels it back at the 13-yard line, brought down to the 17.
This is a key series right here because they do have some momentum offensively.
Williams given plenty of time, throws a dart complete to O.O. out to the 36-yard line. They're going to say that he juggled it and now rule it incomplete. And O.O. was one of the players, Bob, that they have been looking to provide some spark to Illinois' offense. Hasn't given them a lot tonight.
You can see how preseason predictions and things really don't mean anything, because every year, even though you may have the same players back, every team is different. And right now, this Illinois football team, you can see, having lost Rashard Mendenhall, right, they're still searching right now for their identity a little bit on offense. We know they're a spread, but they're kind of evolving right now from a power running game last year to what are we this year.
Williams out of the backfield finds his man. The Vault with a nice move, and he got rocked at the 34-yard line. And Dufresne with a nice run of 16 yards.
That was a great individual effort by Dufresne. He also had a great block from Fulton, the big offensive tackle, 68. But they really like Dufresne as a, they were concerned about his hands coming into this football game. He's caught the football well tonight.
Remember, Illinois last year came back from a 17-point deficit to threaten late in the ballgame before Missouri finally wrapped it up with a late interception. Williams going downtown, wide open. And I mean wide open. That is room service with a chocolate on your pillow. Touchdown, Judson, 65 yards. And there's a flag down on the play in the end zone.
But obviously, just a major breakdown. But again, early in the game, Juice Williams had a wide open receiver. This time, Mark, he puts some air under it, makes it a little bit easier. Obviously, a broken coverage right there.
Juice Williams has shown a lot of progress, Bob, as this game has gone on.
Exactly. And a busted coverage. True Vaughn's the corner, thought he had help from the safety. But all of a sudden, this is a 10-point football game with a lot of time left.
Well, we said that Illinois couldn't stop Missouri. Missouri having a tough time slowing down the juice machine. Well, Will Judson with a touchdown reception a few moments ago makes it a 10-point ball game. Juice Williams with three touchdown passes in his last eight attempts. Daniel, not bad either, with three touchdown passes in his last 11 attempts. And Michael Chlamovsky is going to kick this ball off from his own 15-yard line as a result of the penalty.
Yeah.
Do they kick it to Macklin or not, Bob?
Well, no, but it's really tough after that 15-yard penalty because Missouri is going to be right back here at you with great field position if you squib it. He's going to get it on one pass.
Macklin at the 25. Kind of cruising and looking for a seam. Couldn't get one, but does get good field position at the 44-yard line. What do you make of the new 40-second play clock? How much of an effect
do you think it's been that big of an issue, to be honest. Not that big of a factor.
Chase Daniel, incomplete, broken up at the 30-yard line. Good play that time. And Bellamy comes up for the defense.
And back to your point, though, of this Missouri offense not geared to run it down. All of a sudden, you look up, and it's third and nine, and they've probably used 30 seconds off the clock. So I think the point's well taken. Again, they're in the five wide empty. Another key third down here.
Missouri's offense does like the fact that they think they'll get five or six more plays a game out of it with the new play clock rule. That pass complete at the 37-yard line to Saunders. And that's going to be right at the first down marker for Missouri. Vontae Davis defending on the play, and they're going to give them the first down.
And the accuracy of Chase Daniels, 68% completion guy. I mean, you see it right there. Just catch it in the shotgun, let it rip.
Ron Zook still coaching his guys up on the sidelines. Time winding down.
You notice Missouri huddling, Mark, really for the first time tonight. So they're in a little bit of milk the clock as much as they can right now. They're going to try to use the whole 40-second clock.
Derek Washington on the carry. Now to the 36-yard line. Got a couple on the play. Brought down by Derek Walker. Ron Zook, a tireless, and I mean tireless, recruiter. Folklore has it that back in the day when he was at Florida, Bob, he would make phone calls while in the shower to recruits. And he asked somebody, do they make waterproof cell phones so I can do that? So
yeah, he has done an outstanding job. And he told me, you were listening in on the conversation. I said, are you any different as a coach now at Illinois than you were Florida? He said, none whatsoever. It's all about recruit, getting the right players. He is the same guy who was at Florida, but he's having a lot more success right now.
Second down and eight coming up. Trying to slow down that Missouri Tiger offense. That's Washington down to the 30-yard line as we take a look at the ESPNU All-State Standings review.
Tell you what, USC, you just have to be impressed. I mean, going to Charlottesville, Virginia against a well-coached Al Groh team. I mean, 52-7.
Wow.
They just take it on the road every year in the first game and just amaze you.
Sanchez back healthy again. Looked pretty good today. Daniel with an empty formation. Under 4 minutes to play, a predetermined run. And Chase Daniel gets inside the 30 to the 27-yard line. And that looks like it's going to be right at the first down marker once again.
Chase at about 225 pounds. He's not bashful now. Right here, you look at Missouri going for it on fourth down here.
Why would they do that, Bob?
I think it's a good call late in the game. I mean, he doesn't want to risk kicking a field goal, potentially getting a field goal blocked. Feels like if they can make a first down right now, this game's over. You're always worried about a tired defense jumping off sides right here on a Cadence type play.
Fourth down and one. Daniel's going to keep it, and he is not going to get it. Illinois is going to take over on downs at the 30-yard line. The charge led by David Lindquist and Jerry Brown. So with about 3.5 minutes to go, Juice Williams will get one more crack at it. They're going to get this thing into turbo speed right now. Juice Williams has had a career day passing almost 400 yards through the air and four touchdown passes against just one interception. From their own 30-yard line. First and 10 for the Illini. Williams completes it. Stolen away. Witherspoon. Oh, Houdini. He stole it. Touchdown. Sean Witherspoon knocked Juice Williams out of the game last year. This year, he knocked out the hopes of those Illini fans.
You said it. Second interception of the night for the linebacker, Sean Witherspoon. The freeing the running back has the catch. Great catch from behind. Sean Witherspoon. Witherspoon just comes in and takes that football away from him. And in the end, the Missouri defense comes up with a couple plays. To put this one away.
We've seen some things tonight.
You know, a great effort by Dufresne. The ball thrown behind him, trying to pull it in. Witherspoon just takes it away.
That might just about do it if you're Missouri. Up by 16 points. I think that's 17. Good news. Good news for the Tigers, because Jeremy Maclin, who was taken in for an x-ray a few moments ago, now with an ice pack on that left ankle.
It's been a crazy night, hasn't it? This is only game one.
Yeah, just one of 31 games on the ESPN Family Networks in the next 5 days. Going back a couple of days, coming up after the game, SportsCenter with Neil Everett, Scott Van Pelt, Beanie Wells update on his injury. Rich Rodriguez speaks, and the best team on campus. On the return. That's Garrett. Make that Jenkins.
Well, Mark, great news from the Missouri sideline. X-rays are negative. It is not broken. He will receive further treatment when they get back to Columbia. But the good news is the X-rays did come back negative on the left ankle of Jeremy Maclin.
That was kind of strange, because as we saw before, it was a non-contact type of injury situation where he just ran off the line of scrimmage and didn't look like he cut particularly hard and turned his ankle anywhere. 3 minutes, 3 seconds to go. Williams fires it complete to Judson, who has two touchdown catches in the game tonight. One more look at that injury that Maclin suffered.
Yeah, really strange. I thought it was a cramp at first, but you do see that left ankle kind of give way right there. But always good news, Mark, when that ice is on the ankle and not on that knee.
Here's Aurelius Ben. And Ben down to the 26-yard line. You look at the quarterbacks in the Big 12. You know, Reesing at Kansas. Daniel at
Bradford in Oklahoma. Yep. Harrell out at Texas Tech.
Our guy Hawkins, coach's son at
much improved.
Colorado. Yep. 14-yard pickup on the play. Williams steps up. Down to the 23-yard line. Up down by Chavis.
I wonder why Juice Williams is still in there. I think that's a legitimate point to keep in mind. He's still in the developmental stage as a quarterback, and every snap is a valuable snap.
Ron Zook in his fourth season on the sidelines, watching his quarterback do his thing. Incomplete that time, though. Six returning starters for Illinois on offense and six on defense.
You know, the players were telling me yesterday, Ron Zook squats over 500 pounds.
I believe it, too.
And he benches over 350. I mean, the guy is a workout warrior now. Those are big numbers.
Yeah, he was telling me before the game he had to get his shoulder cleaned out earlier this year. His shoulders are so messed up from all that lifting. Williams Wide open at the 10.
Uh-oh.
We're not saying that's a mistake. We're saying that's his name. Uh-oh. Down to the 4-yard line. It's Michael Uh-oh Manawanui. His first two names are Michael Patrick.
I'll tell you what, this has a chance to be a 52-42 game. Bunch of points in college football.
This is Ford. Ford cut back, but was stopped.
Again, Weatherspoon.
He's putting a hat on some people tonight. Sean Weatherspoon with an interception for a touchdown a few moments ago. All-conference pick out of Jasper, Texas. He's an NFL prospect. Second and goal coming up. Williams on the fade. Incomplete. DeVault almost had another touchdown catch.
I think the positive for Illinois, you come out of here finding some young receivers.
Missouri on the cusp of making it 4 consecutive wins against their border rivals from Illinois. These two campuses separated by about 250 miles of highway. Third down and goal coming up for Illinois. Williams looks over to the sideline, gets the call. Williams, he's going to do it himself, or try to. Brought down after a gain of about 2. Fourth and goal coming up now. And this Missouri defense resolute until the end.
Question is, did Illinois call timeout right here and try to get another play? They're going to hurry it up and try to get one more.
Why not? Are they going to get it off? Yes, they do. Williams staying alive.
It's wide open.
Touchdown, Illini.
How about that?
Uh-oh, makes the catch.
I'll tell you who's sick. The Missouri defensive staff. Because stats are stats. At the end of the year,
so you try to say
you're going to look back and say Illinois scored 42 or 43 points on us.
And you can't explain that.
Can't
two of them
it.
Were late that really didn't matter.
Right. Contract time, it's a bottom line deal, Mark.
Williams with his 5th touchdown pass of the night. A career high for him. And he's passed now for 451 yards.
This extra point means a lot of things to a lot of people somewhere in this country.
Funny how that works. That's the end of the game. Ron Zook's team falls to Missouri for the 4th consecutive time. The final score, 42-52, in a very exciting offensively played game here at the Edward Jones Dome. SportsCenter coming up next, and we'll be on ESPN News for Postgame Extra. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. A lot of football is up in the air for grabs tonight. It was all good for the Tigers. For Todd Harris.